Okay, good morning. My name is Emilia Persson. I'm a project manager at Dedicom, at the Department of Research and Development. Dedicom is the organization in the Netherlands that makes information accessible for people with a print impairment. So we make information accessible for people with a visual impairment. And this includes, for instance, blind people, but also people with low vision, and a large target group also are the dyslexic people that Neil already mentioned this morning. I was asked to tell you something about DAISY. Now, I know that part of the audience is very well familiar with DAISY. But my talk is more aimed at the people who don't know so much about DAISY. My apology to the other half, maybe, of the audience. What I'm going to talk about is DAISY, what it is, and I'll show you how it works. I'll pay especially some attention to mathematics and DAISY, and I'll tell you something about the current developments. Well, DAISY. DAISY is an acronym. It stands for Digital Accessible Information System, and it is a digital format to represent multimedia information. And multimedia information, in this case, you could think of audio, text, images, and in the future also, for instance, video. DAISY is an open standard. It's worldwide in use in many countries, and it's developed and maintained by the DAISY Consortium. The DAISY Consortium is a consortium that was formed in the 90s, and there are many... Oh, okay. Well, this is a bit confusing. Okay, maybe I should sit more like this. Okay. Didn't you get anything of what I said? Or yes? Oh, okay. So the DAISY Consortium is composed of organizations who work especially for the visually impaired, like libraries for the blind, producers for blind and visually impaired people. But there are also many friends of the consortium, vendors of equipment, developers of new tools, etc. I think the best thing to do is first show you, give you a little demonstration of how a DAISY book works. I think the starting point to keep in mind is to think of audiobooks on audio cassettes. We had that in the Netherlands and in many countries. That was one way of providing blind people and visually impaired people with a means to have access to content, to books. When you have, for instance, a textbook when you're in school, and it's a bit of a larger type of textbook, then you would have typically like 10 or 20 maybe cassettes, but all of them having two sides. And the only way to navigate through them would be fast forward or rewind and know which cassette to pick. With DAISY, there's a huge improvement in the navigation through your content. Now I have to put it on, but yeah, we'll see what happens.
Welcome by Victor Reader.
With DAISY, you typically will have your book on one CD or on an SD memory card, for instance. So that's much more portable than having like 10 or 15 cassette tapes. And the book will be much more structured. So I've put in a CD in here, and I've picked an English spoken book so that maybe you can follow what's being said. But the Daisy player is a Dutch one, so the acoustic signals coming from the Daisy player will be in Dutch, but I will tell you what's happening here. So this is a very simple version of a Daisy player, very suitable for people who don't want a very complicated device. There are much more sophisticated ones that you can look at after my talk. This one is has big buttons like a cassette player for play, fast forward, and rewind. So I hope this will work like this. I'll let you hear how it sounds.
Popular culture, an introduction. The aim of this book is twofold. First, to introduce students and other interested readers to the study of contemporary popular culture.
So that would be just play and stop. But because this book has added structure to it, I can navigate through the levels of the book. And levels of a book would typically be the chapters of a book, the subsections of a book, the preface. And I'll let you hear this.
Niveau 1.
So now it's at level 1. I'm now at level 1. Level 1 will be the chapter level. So if I go to the next one within this level,
chapter 2, television.
So you will hear it will go to chapter 2. If I go to the next one,
chapter 3, fiction.
So this is a way to navigate through the book, a bit like a sighted person would do, just search for the next chapter or the next subsection. You can also navigate on page level, so if your teacher tells you look at page 87 in your book, you can, with a more complicated version of this player, you can type in 87, go to that page, and you're immediately there where your classmates will be. Or if you have to do your homework, you can find the paragraph where you are supposed to do your assignments. Another nice feature is that, I hope you can hear that, is that I can speed it up or let it go, the rate go slower.
Reading the Popular, Big Culture and Environment, first published in 1933. F.R. Leavis and Dennis Thompson, 1977. Condemn popular fiction for offering addictive forms of conversation and distraction.
So this is. There are more settings that you can adjust, but this is to show you that a user can do a lot to accommodate his preferences when reading a book. Well, on the screen you can see listed some of the features, like the audio is rather good quality, even when you make many copies of your master recording. Still, it's unlike with an audio cassette recording where the quality diminishes. Here, the audio quality stays the same. And also, when you use your book, fast forwarding, rewinding, etc., it doesn't spoil your book. The portability, well, I already mentioned you don't have all these cassette tapes. There is this. There are several levels of navigation, several ways of navigating through the book. You can adjust the rate, and there are several other settings that you can change. Now, I just showed you a hardware player, and there are many. Here's a smaller one, but this is a very sophisticated one. You can do much more with this. And this is a very portable one. especially for blind users. It was designed especially for blind users, so there is no screen on it, just buttons. You can feel what you can do, and everything is in an acoustic signal. So I showed you these hardware versions. There are also software versions to use on your computer. And this is one example of them. This is the GH player, and I have permission from the vendor GH to use this. This is an early release. It's not yet the final one, so it's not perfect yet, but still I can show you what I mean. First I will show you a simple book, quite a simple book. It's an Italian book, and here you can see that you have the text and you will hear the audio, but the audio was recorded with synthetic voice because I didn't have an Italian reader at home to record. So I hope, we'll see how it sounds to you. A software player would typically have, at the bottom you see some buttons to play and go forward and go backward. There are some navigation, there's a section where you can use to navigate through the book. So you can go by page level, you can go by section level, you can even go per sentence, or for some books even per word. You can go through your book. And at the top there is a button bar that you can use to set your preferences. So for instance, you can zoom in. You can change the contrast in the book, you can change the colors in the background and the foreground, so you can choose a different font. You can adjust, of course, the volume and again the rate, which is represented by a running character or a more slow going character. And you can change, if you want to, you can, this is set to audio. You can also use synthetic speech with this GH player. Now I'll have to find the audio. Audio. Can I, for a moment, if I can zoom, because it will be quicker. Yeah. Okay, this always works, of course, but yeah. why isn't this working? Before this book. Okay, yeah. Okay, I'll start to play.
Modulo IP, le influenze del mercato sulle scelte economiche individuali. Page 191. Unità didattica 3. La ricerca dell'equilibrio dell'impresa sul mercato.
Now, to me this sounds a bit fast. To the Italian people I think not, but so... Sorry? It's normal. It's normal, yeah, okay. So I would put the rate...
Per orientarci.
A bit slower.
Campione. Temi portati.
What you can see...
Entro campione.
What happens is that...
Costi.
While you hear the audio, the text is highlighted with it, and this is a synchronization between the text and the audio. And as Neil already told, this can be very helpful for people with dyslexia, but also for people with low vision, because they have some support, and people with other learning disabilities. Here at the left in the screen, you can see there is a, if I can zoom in on that, you can see there's a kind of a table of contents, and I can go to, for instance, 3.1 by clicking on that, and this is a way to navigate through my book. Again, there is the structure, the DAISY structure, that I use to navigate through it. You can see that you can even have levels beneath that. Also, you can have the pages. Now, on the left, you can see the pages, and you can say, okay, I want to go to some special page and continue my reading over there. For DAISY books, now you just have seen an audio-only book, which I showed you with the hardware player. You've seen a text and audio book, and you can also have text-only books. A text-only book would be useful for someone using Braille, for instance, or also synthetic speech. The reading material that they make available in this way is really everything that you can think of. So leisure reading, newspapers and magazines, textbooks in education, and that varies from really from the beginning of primary school until academic level, so universities, and professional literature. Special benefits from the DAISY, using the DAISY format, is the portability, the audio quality, no physical deterioration, the navigation that it provides. You can search if you have a text only or a text and audio book. You can really search within your text, so you can really look for some words and start reading from there. There are adjustable settings, and another feature is that skippability of elements. So if you are listening to an audio cassette, you have to go through everything that's on it. For instance, if all the videos are in there, you have to either listen to them or fast forward through them. In DAISY, there is the possibility that you can say, okay, I do want to read the footnotes too, or I want them turned off. And that goes for footnotes, but also for other elements that you can have in a book. Well, we are here for the accessibility of math and sciences. And so I will talk a little bit about math in DAISY. Until recently, you could include math in a DAISY book, but only by providing it as an image. So a formula would be turned into an image, and an image in itself is not very accessible to people with a visual impairment. So you would have to add some text, and that text would be available in text format or in an audible format. But you would have no navigation within the formula. You could not use any user-defined settings to represent this formula. And because the DAISY 3 standard has this possibility to extend the DAISY standard with other standards, the DAISY consortium said, okay, let's install a working group to look especially at this problem. Can we extend DAISY so that mathematics gets more accessible? The working group has, I'm part of that working group, and several members of the working group are here today in the audience also. The working group has actually come up with a modular extension to DAISY. It was approved last year. And it also happens to be the first modular extension to DAISY, so we hope that other applications will follow. At the right you can see the Daisy logo, and there is the special one where Mafamel is added. To extend Daisy for Mafamel, for mathematics, sorry, we used Mafamel. Mafamel is a W3C standard, so you're quite safe at that side. Math is saved as structured information, not in some specific rendering, and it allows you to present whatever content you have in a wide range of formats. For instance, again, as a graphic formula, a two-dimensional one, or as braille, as text-to-speech, as large print. Also, MathML enables you to navigate at a very fine level through the formula, and I will demonstrate that in a moment. And again, we have the possibility of synchronized highlighting of audio and text, even within the formula. So I'll show you an example of this in GH Player. And this is really special because GH Player, they already have an established version of GH Player for all the Daisy books that are around. But this one that I'm showing you is already prepared for the use of math. So I'm going to open a math book, and now you can see a splash screen coming up that says Math Player that Neil talked about this morning. It's the case that GH works together with, for instance, Design Science, and uses the technology of Math Player to make math work. So I have an example here of a book with formulas in it. It is a Daisy book, a valid Daisy book. And let me put on the volume. Yeah.
Is
so now
f equals fraction y minus y sub 0 over x minus x sub 0 n fraction area and circumference.
So what you could hear, maybe I should do the formula again. What you will hear is m equals, and then it will say something like start fraction or begin fraction, and sorry?
Just fraction.
Oh, fraction, and end fraction. Sorry?
Technical assistance.
So I'll let you hear this again.
M, open x sub 0, parental y sub 0, close, is m equals fraction y minus y sub 0 over x minus x sub 0, n fraction.
Okay. Now I'm thinking as a student, well, this was a bit fast. I want to explore this formula.
And
so
fraction,
I go into the word
area
navigation
of the circle with the radius of orbit represented by the variable.
Word navigation mode. So if I go again to this formula,
m equals fraction y minus y sub.
Okay, now in the middle of the formula, and now with my arrow buttons, I can navigate through it. So
0 over x minus x sub 0 comma.
So what you will hear is x minus x sub 0. And I can also go
x sub
backwards.
Minus x 0 minus y fraction equals.
So maybe for this formula it doesn't seem so impressive, but there are very huge formulas where it can be really practical to go through it part by part.
Can you skip?
Can you skip the formulas?
Can you skip some expressions?
Well, yeah, you can go to another level and then it just reach the complete thing. Oh, you mean like in Lambda? No, you don't mean that. No. You asked that in your case.
Yes, in Lambda. He was meaning
something
like
Lambda. Yeah, something.
Lambda, yeah.
Yeah, he was meaning something.
Yeah, something in parentheses, or you could say skip denominator.
Skip denominator. No, that's not there at the moment. But because we use MathML, you could make it like that. So you could have your application do that.
Okay.
So I just showed you a math and ML aware player. Another question. Okay. Yeah.
Is this working?
Yeah.
Yeah. In regard to the previous question, sometimes it's valuable to be able to just characterize some part of the equation.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Good. Sometimes it's useful to characterize some parts of the equations as, for example, parenthetical parts of the equation, as just that without explaining them. Mm-hmm. Can you do that?
At the moment, that functionality isn't there, but because you save all the information in MathML within the Daisy book, you could program something. You could add this functionality. It's not there yet, but it might be a good idea to propose that to, for instance, GH and tell them, well, I would really like this functionality added.
Yeah, like in the math genie, it would say x equals begin fraction, sub expression, and then something else, or component one, or something like that. And then you can go back and dive into that.
Mm-hmm.
To better understand it, and sometimes that's really good for editing.
Yeah.
Because people want to get an idea of the structure without too much.
Exactly. So this is just the beginning of this, and again, because it's all in MathML, you have this structure, and you could make use of that, and have some program or some application that says, okay. First, I do the coarse level, and then I go to the fine grained level.
Right. MathML is very handy for telling you where chunks of the equation begin and end because of its tree structure. And that's what the MathJD does. It really uses MathML to its fullest. I was wondering whether you're going to implement. Are you planning on implementing those features in the future?
Well, I'm not from GH, mm-hmm. but I can certainly suggest it to them.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I can talk more.
Yeah, okay. So an advanced MathML player, as you just saw, will have a native understanding of MathML structures and semantics. It is able to render and navigate within the MathML content in an intelligent way, and we may be even more intelligent in the future with the suggestions from the audience. The math image is created dynamically, and the reader is able, using such a player, to adjust the way how your math is read. Again, this is also in the beginning stage. And there are many ideas about how you could improve on this. So the production of Daisy books in general would be done in production centers, well, in countries, well, in Italy you have them too. So you will have studios for the recording of books, and you will have text production for Braille or for magnification purposes. You can also have, as an individual, you can also produce Daisy, and that's what I wanted to show you, how you can yourself at home or at work produce a Daisy document. I will use, it's very short outline here, I will use Word 2007. It will also work with 2003 and Word 2002 or XP. I will make a Word document with math in it, save it as Daisy from within Word, and then play it in the player if there's still time for that. So I'll show you. This is Word 2007.
Of course.
Yeah, I can.
Clear.
I can type in that. To save some time, I already prepared a document. This is not a lot. Okay, yeah. I added some profiles, so I used the profiles, the styles in Word. So this is title, this has a title style. There are headings in it, subheadings, and here you can see at the bottom there's a math formula, and I made that with the the equation builder that's provided with Word. Then I go to over here, where you have your normal buttons like new, open, save, etc. And you can see I have installed a save as DAISY add-in, which you can download for free. If I choose that save as DAISY, a window should appear. Yes, there it is. It will take the title, the part that I marked as title. It will add some extra things, and when I choose... Oh, this wasn't maybe not so bad. Okay. Then it will translate into... it will take the Word document, include it in with the math, and it will translate it into an XML document, a DAISY XML document. And without... Okay, okay, successfully translated the document. And when I go to... Now there is... There should be... Oh, yeah, it is. So there is a My Stay in Milan XML document. And this document will have math in it. I can put it in the GH player just like that. So
my
Stay
in Milan, Edmonia for soon. My Stay in Milan, Chapter 1, Saturday.
So now I'll go to the math part.
1, 2.2, do some mathematics. Let me insert an equation. Open X, close, close, super in English.
Yeah, okay.
MathML error, sum from k equals to 0 of n MathML error, open n over k close.
Yeah, I can hear some laughing. as I said, it's not perfect yet. So there was a slight mistake in the translation within the formula, but this is the fine-tuning stage where they are. As I said, this is an early release, and I'm already very proud that I can show you this. Because this is directly, you're just sitting at your desk, you open Word, you make your Word document, insert your math, and you have a ready-to-play DAISY XML file. The DAISY consortium also has a DAISY pipeline, and part of that is that you can take this DAISY XML file, put it in that pipeline. It's also for free, you can download it for free and use it for free, and it will turn it into a complete DAISY book, which you would be able to play with your DAISY player, your hardware DAISY player, for instance. So I'll leave it to that due to time. Maybe there are more questions which Bernard maybe will not allow. So you can talk
I
to me in the break.
I can't.
No, I understand. So you can talk to me in the break, and also if you would like a demonstration, an individual demonstration. I have three types of DAISY players and software one. Please come to me and ask me. Thank you.